Howdy of you delicious people, I'm here today to play more Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Mutant Madness. So we are hopefully here today to complete a level, but ultimately while I was playing last time, I'd also saw an image that ultimately I'm going to pause here and then ultimately you're going to see. So let's pause here, let's get to that image, and then we'll ultimately get into gameplay. Let's go out of our way to pause here, and I'll be back. Alrighty, Ace Duck. So evidently this image is, what's wrong? The crash happens all the time. Lend a hand. We're too far from the city to get the turtle blimp. Well, I have an idea. I guess they're just kind of in the middle of the snow somewhere of sorts. Alright, so let's pause here. Let's get into gameplay. Hopefully we can beat this level today so we can showcase this level being beaten. So let's pause here and hope we can beat this level. Alright, so reasonably, we're going to claim some rewards here, because that's what we do with our time. So anyways, I hope we are going to be able to beat this level today, please. Let us just beat the level. Let's beat that. Let's just win today. For the love of all that's turtles, can we just beat this level? I'd really appreciate it. It would be great to just beat a level today. Oh man, if only we could just win. So let's ultimately try and see what happens here with this level. Come on, everybody, just chime in and everybody just win. Come on, Raph, use your levels. Use your fighting feet. Just kick people in the face. Just kill everyone. Kill everyone. Die. Justifiably. Because reasonably, that's probably what you're going to do probably soon here. Come on. Yes. Take everyone down. Take them down, please. I'd appreciate it. Concussion City. Yeah. Concussions. Concussions are abound. Yes. Please, everyone, get knocked down. Please. God dang it, every single time. It's always the same old song and dance. You have four characters left. Let me pause here. Let me see what I can do to get this battle crate. I hit the wrong button. Isn't that great? You hit the wrong button. Come on. What button can we hit here? What button can we play? Adventure. That's a button we can hit. Alright, so let's go into the level. Let's try and configure some other characters so we can try to beat this level. We're going to have to adjust some things here. Personally, I think that we probably need to switch Genghis and Leonardo. That's what I'm thinking. Because we're going to have to switch these characters. Hopefully. Come on, Leonardo. As you die right away. Thanks for the help. Thanks for nothing. Thanks for donut holes worth of nothing. I really appreciate your Bubkiss ability to do jack crap nothing and then just die fairly quickly. It really means a lot whenever you are worthless to die right away. Just it really helps out the cause. It really helps out so much when you have a character that repetitiously just dies. Oh, come on. Okay, I'm switching Leo and Slash. I'm switching. Dang it. Every single time with this man, every single time. Every time that man has just fell afoot, he's just dead. Come on, Genghis, live, live, live. Come on, come on, come on. Somebody kill some people. Take them down. Donnie's dead, so in my head, it's freaking just. We're close to just losing this whole thing again. Why is this level so hard? Why is this level so hard? Why is it so difficult? We have to pause here to get this battle crate. All right, so we're back. We're getting ready. We're getting ready for the spaghetti of our lives. We're getting ready for the good times that we are about to have by just probably roasting and toasting and dying. Okay. Now that we have Splinter up to a decent level, which I hope we decently can freaking figure this whole thing out, let's take Slash out, put Splinter in, see what happens with this one. Levels, hitting buttons. Come on, everybody. Just do the dance. Do the seductive dance of winning. Please. We need to concuss some people. Come on, we need to do that concuss, please. I'd appreciate it if we could just knock down some folks. You know, because that's what we gotta do in this game. Knock some folks down. Come on. Come on. Come on, yes, please. Live, live, kill some more people. Yes. Please keep doing the thing that I wanted you to do, which is take down more folks. Come on, yes. Splinter, live a little bit longer there, buddy. Live a little bit longer. I would appreciate it if you could live a little bit longer. Oh my God. Whoo! Oh my, are we gonna live? Are we gonna beat this level? Are we gonna have some good times here? Oh my God, please. Please. I've been waiting for this moment for seemingly a week now. Oh my God. Thank goodness. Wow, thank God I had Splinter in that level. Cause good God, that level took forever to beat. Numerous days. Numerous lurking in the shadows of thinking, am I gonna beat this freaking level? Thank goodness. Oh my God, we beated that level. We took it to town. We just like took a shovel to it, just farted all over. We just took it off to the side and that's what we did. Oh my God, and now we have this boss level that's probably gonna suck. Probably is gonna suck. But anyways, let's go into the inspiration of good times. I don't think we're gonna beat this with this kind of. I don't think this team is gonna work. I just don't. I could be wrong, but I think I'd rather be correct about things, respectfully. Come on. Please, please, come on. Live, Genghis, live. Don't die yet. Don't die yet. Just scrapingly stay alive. Oh no. Come on, 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 come on. Kill, kill. I shouldn't probably say kill in a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles video game, but still, I just want some people to be taken out. Please. I would appreciate it. I would really appreciate it if we can beat two levels in this episode. I would really like to just, yeah. Donnie is at full health. Oh my god, that boss level was actually much easier than the level I played previously. Thank goodness, the gracious of level. Yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah, that felt so good to beat two levels in one gosh darn episode. Just the inspiration, the motivation of just going and feeling good. Ooh. Finally, that is underneath my cap, so to speak. Just keep going good. Just keep having good times. Only good times happening over here. Just keep letting things be well and merry and such. Christmas and such. Speaking of which, that has no tie to what I just said. I had just like watched an interview of Arnold Schwarzenegger, and he was talking about the very first Terminator. And I thought the discussion that he was having was really interesting, because I found out that actually Arnold was originally going to be Kyle Reese's character. I'm like, man, would that have been interesting if Arnold was Reese and someone else was the Terminator? He doesn't feel pity or remorse, and he absolutely will not be stopped. That would have been awesome. I wanted to see Arnold as Kyle Reese. But so reasonably, originally the movie was gonna have OJ be the Terminator, which reasonably at that time, I probably would have been okay with that. And then Arnold was going to be originally Kyle Reese. But Arnold talked James Cameron into basically being Terminator, because like Arnold was basically breaking down like how the Terminator was supposed to act. So James was just like, you know what, since you really thought this whole thing through, how about you just freaking be the Terminator? And Arnold's like, I don't know, like I really like the Terminator doesn't have much lines, and ultimately, like, Kyle Reese has a lot more lines. Like, I feel like I'd be going backwards to play a character that has fewer lines. And so, ultimately, we're going to pause here for the conclusion of this story, which we already know what the conclusion is. So Arnold talked himself into being the Terminator, and of course I said in some other previous interview that or some previous interview, some previous video, not previous interview, that ultimately that whole like I'll be back thing was I will be back. And then they had like 10 takes supposedly of that same line, and ultimately they kind of delivered it 10 different ways, and ultimately that's the one take was the one that they went with. Arnold was saying that I'll be back was weak. Like it sounded weak with his accent. And so that was like the whole reason for them to kind of nix the whole I will be back or I'll be back. And ultimately funny enough, like I guess James Cameron, ultimately his thing is like, hey, if he writes something, like don't F up his writing. Like, dude, I wrote this story. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be amazing. So don't try to adjust my story for me. Which I kind of find that funny, to just be like, hey, like, the guy has done Avatars and Titanics and everything like that. So yeah, just let the guy just like you are his mold of clay. Let him sculpt you. And reasonably, if you don't like it after that, then like you can just be haunted by that for the rest of your life. I did the one James Cameron movie that wasn't that good. Oh no, why? Dude, it's gonna make you tons and tons of money later on, as well as if they ever do a franchise out of that. Like, it's not like Titanic was ever gonna have numerous sequels, but I'm assuming Avatar still is, which ultimately is taking forever to come out because ultimately they were filming like Avatar 2 while like Endgame was being filmed. So yeah, it's reasonably, yeah, like they were doing it. They were popping that bad boy out, and I don't know how it's gonna go out now with like they're probably gonna have to wait till like 2023 or something for Avatar 2 to come out now because of Cove and the vids that are all being sent of people saying, "Hey, yeah, Avatar 2 was a thing. It was cool, bro. It was cool." It could have been cool, but you know what? We just gotta wait a long time for it to come out because reasons of the new normal, the new times. The new... Dude, I'm all this guy's almost dead, but yet reasonably I'm gonna die still, because we're gonna die at the same time. I bet. Yeah. Oh. Reasons. Raging reasons for being just. Why can't I just look at that bug and just be like, yeah. So let's pause here again for more battle crates. Here's also one thing that I have to mention. Have you ever drank citrus punch? You haven't lived until you've drank citrus punch. Coming out of the Tropicana whatever thing, you haven't lived until you've had citrus punch. If you have never been punched by citrus in your life, what are you doing with your life? Evidently not being punched by citrus. That is such a stupid, like, I'm not being sponsored by that. It's just a joke. Because ultimately, I've been drinking that a lot lately. Because ultimately, switching some kind of dietary stuff, trying to do something different, trying to be healthier, even though reasonably, when you at some points eat probably two meals a day, that is probably considered healthy most of the point. Because really, you don't actually need a breakfast, but you can just kind of eat on your way through breakfast, which normally that's something that I just don't have the time to do, which ultimately probably led to me being sick, but still, I probably don't eat like throughout the time of day of which I do things, and so like really, it's just two just solid meals and then just like a one whole cookie here and there, or one whole like apple or orange or something recently. So yeah, but tightening the belt a little bit, I guess. Not really. We're still at the same weight that we were X amount of time ago. Even actually after I was like sick, I actually like after I felt better, like I gained like 10 pounds back, because ultimately I was around like 260, And I was like, oh my God, I'm almost 260. But then I realized, oh yeah, that's because I'm effing sick. And then ultimately when I once I started got healthy, I got to 270, and I'm like, I wanted to be thinner, but when looking at it, I was like, I wasn't going through healthy means of being thin anyways, so it was like, eh, like as long as we're not back to where we started when we started to lose weight and such, like I'm not really trying to diet or whatever. It's just like the weight is just like, 'cause that's stupid. 'Cause ultimately it's like, oh yeah, like well, how about you just get on a treadmill and how about you just you just run 12 miles a day, and then ultimately the pounds will probably fly off or whatever. Yeah, I'm sure. But ultimately it's just like I'm at least trying to do like to like maintaining a lot. So that's great. I don't know why I'm talking about all this stuff, because it doesn't matter. But reasonably, hey guys, reasonably, it's either be as healthy as you could probably think that you are and then get really sick. Or just hope for the best for the near future of whatever you end up doing with your body and whatever. Reasonably to me, like a lot of people, like I used to like heavily every single day just like work out every single day. And most of the time I would like it got to where like I was just working out my upper body and that was it. And then eventually I got to just going like, I guess I should do stuff with my legs, right? Like I used to walk a lot, so that would be like my exercise for legs, but ultimately I started to do like other things to like do more like upper and lower body stuff. Yeah. So reasonably, if you're not doing that, then reasonably, like during that whole time I was doing like jobs that were like furniture movers and stuff like that, whereas all like or appliance movers or stuff like that, whereas like I could get my workouts from my job. And then I was working out on top of that, like taking like an hour or out like an hour or more, and I was just like, it probably you shouldn't go that long. It should probably take like a decent probably like cut that in half and probably do like a 30-minute workout. But I was just adamant of just like I wanna be strong. I wanna be strong as humanly possible. And yeah, I was, but then I ultimately was just like, I no. It got to the point where I was just like, yeah, I'm really strong, but heaven forbid like sleeping is the most difficult thing in the world to do. Because like the entire body it was like the most uncomfortable thing to sleep in a bed, because I would just like turn somehow, I'd wake up, I'd turn here, wake up. It was like, oh man, like I would get these like weird, like I would get it to like my hips, like if I slept the wrong way, like I would just be like, it was a miserable thing. Breeze, it's have has anybody got this for ultimately, like if you bend your knees while you're sleeping, you get cramps. That sucks. You're just sleeping and you're like, I guess my body is gonna say, hey, how about you bend your legs? And then you get freaking cramps from while and you wake up from cramps being in your leg while you're sleeping. What a weird thing to talk about today, but anyways, yeah, it happens. Ultimately, it's probably been a while since I've talked about it, but yeah, that's the life of which we all lead, is like people end up just getting injured by sleeping. I slept and broke my face and broke my nose, or I slept and fell down a flight of stairs. I don't know how it happened, but it happened. Man, has that ever happened to anybody where they like Where they would like wake up and just like have like this horrific like awakening of just not being sick or whatever, but just like being like injured or hurt or whatever. They can't explain why it happened. I don't know. We gotta get some unsolved mysteries going on in here. Johnny went home to and slept really, really good to be woken up with with two broken legs, a broken nose. And a magazine of men's health on his on his by his alarm clock. Oh, come on. Okay, so evidently we need to maybe we need to take Splinter out of this one. Put me in, coach. I'm ready to play today. You can be said. I don't know why I always go to that song. It's a fun song and it's a stupid song that doesn't make any sense rationally, because like of course you can't really do baseball now, but still it's a weird goofy song. Oh, come on. God, these characters are so weak and yet not strong enough to. Or they are still, but they're still strong enough. God, I think this one is gonna heavily take some, like, figure placement of where to put everybody. I think the weaker characters are probably on this side, so I'm thinking probably have the stronger characters on that side. So, Raph will be on that side. We'll have Genghis here, and not Michelangelo there. We'll have Donnie there. I guess we'll have Mikey in the middle, Pickle in the middle there, and then Leo will probably be here. Let's see what happens with that. Wow, Leonardo just gets nerfed right away. Just right away nerfed. Yeah, like that side is really strong. So. Gotta get really strong characters on that side. Yeah, bow, chicka, bow, bow, bow. Yeah, there's a lot of weaker characters on that side. Okay, so I get it. I gotta. Maybe I'm gonna have really. Maybe here's my plan again. Get the weaker character, or get the strong characters on the weaker side, so they blow through the weaker characters to make their way to the strong characters. More than likely, that usually doesn't work, but F it. Just. Well, we're trying some things out here, so we're gonna try to strong characters over here. We'll have Donnie and I'm gonna put Slash. I do not like no Raph and then Slash. So come on, come on, come on. Yeah, so blow through all of the weak characters. I would appreciate it. Yeah, and then make our way to the stronger characters. Yes, thank you. I'm liking this. I'm liking this strategy. It feels smart even though it's not. Because ultimately now these characters are fairly weak and we only have a couple left. And yeah, this yeah. It was a good idea, but the only problem is when the other characters, like the strong characters, need somebody to hold them up. And I don't think Slash is that character. Some character needs to be here to probably stall them or slow the strong characters down, which might be Skarg. But he's probably gonna die right away, I'm assuming. Yeah, that's what I thought. God, well, this is gonna be a loss, obviously. I'm not even, like, what is the. We didn't even get time to even use Skarg. That's because he was on the weak. That's because he was on the strong side. Let's pause here. Okay, I have an idea. So maybe I keep Raph on. So I'll have the two characters, but Raph will be where Donnie is. So, and then Donnie will be there. And then we'll just probably have, instead of Skarg, we'll probably have Splinter. Even though he's probably gonna die fairly quickly. Donnie, you're probably gonna die fairly quickly. I know you. You're probably gonna die. Appreciate your death, but I know it's going to happen. Come on. Come on, get rid of the weak characters, get rid of the weak characters. Appreciate you. Gosh darn it. That sucked. So, getting tight on time. I'm getting tight on the time. So don't have Donnie, it's gotta be someone else. It's gotta be somebody else. April, maybe? But switch April and this seems like a horrible decision. Horrible decisions are being made right now. These are mistakes. Yes, horrible mistakes. This is bad. I have a feeling that these characters are gonna die and then April's gonna be left. Yeah, this went awful. This went awful. Man. All right. So we are gonna try to beat this level next time. I feel like we were close here, but I think we just need a little bit more resources or some refiguring of who we're gonna send in here to probably get killed at some point. But it seems like we were close with this level, and that's all I could say. But I'm gonna go out of my way to say goodbye, everybody. Bye, everybody.